Joining me now is Councilmember Kenny Glavan. We have you on here because we're now in October and it's Real Men Wear Pink Month. What does that mean?
And it means a lot. You know, in this times that we're in with the pandemic and everything, people are looking for ways to show the generosity of their hearts, and Real Men Wear Pink is an excellent opportunity for that, and we're seeing it. We're seeing it with businesses, individuals, and the community getting involved.
It's all about fighting cancer, and it's a benefit for the American Cancer Society. Do I have that right?
You have that exactly right, but it, you know, more importantly, the initiative is early detection. Mm-hmm. And so the awareness speaks to that and promotes that. And we hear so many testimonies from people that have had loved ones and family members and friends that have fought this disease. And a lot of them have beaten it. Some mm-hmm. of them have succumbed to it. And we're just supporting that initiative and letting people know that we're there for them and we're going to make a difference.
From what I gathered, there are 29 local ambassadors, but there are only two that I hear about.
Well, there's 29, and yeah, me and Representative Felsher are kind of leading the pack, but it's not him and I, it's the community mm-hmm. that has stepped up, and we're proud to be a catalyst for that. Between Kevin and I, we've probably raised half of the $60,000 so far, and we're not stopping there. We got a pickleball tournament coming up. Already, we got about $5,000 in donations.
For the pickleball?
For the pickleball.
Well, you know, those two pickleball people, they just don't stop. They well, really are dynamos.
Well, it's going to be a pink pickleball tournament. It's going to be a lot of fun. And at the end of the day, we did some good things for a great cause.
Now, what are other things that you're seeing happening in the community when it comes to Real Men Wear Pink?
Well, we see restaurants stepping up and donating a percent of their sales. We got the city of Biloxi that's going to do an event on the steps of City Hall, not only in Biloxi, but other communities.
Explain what that is, or is it too early?
No, it's not at all. We have pink illuminated bags that people can purchase for about $10. Mm-hmm. We'll put them on the steps of the various city halls, and they'll have a name of their loved one that is either fighting it or in memory of those individuals. So it'll be a very emotional time, and it'll just show we care.
Now, how can someone be part of that drive
sure.
for the luminaries?
All right, so you can go to Real Men Wear Pink, you Gulf Coast, you can get some information there. You can, whether it's Kevin or one of the other 29 ambassadors.
You.
That's right, man. And if you want one of those bags, we'll give you the opportunity to purchase one of those, and we'll tell you how to do that, and we'll recognize you during
yeah,
that event.
It's going to be a very moving display, I believe.
Absolutely.
Okay, now, there at this pickleball event that's coming up later this month, there are two teams that I keep hearing about, and Representative Felsher was here the other day, and he said he had nothing to do with the naming of those teams.
Well, we did. The pickleball organization kind of tagged him, the Felsher Flounders, and I'm the Glavan Gulls.
So well, they soar.
That's right, and so it's kind of in that Gulf Coast genre, and we're going to have a lot of fun with it, Team Felsher, Team Glavan, and all the pickleball players. We're going to have a great day towards the end of October.
So they can go to Kenny Glavan on Facebook, they can go to Real Men.
We're Pink Gulf Coast.
Okay.
And they can get that information, and they can call me too if they want. 228-223-3477. I'll give you all the information you need.
Say that number again.
228-223-3477. Real Men Wear Pink, and we're going to do it for a great cause.
You are just as brave as Felsher. He came on here and gave his phone number too. I would be remiss if I didn't ask you about what you're seeing in this pandemic in regards to tourism.
Yeah, well, you know, people are getting cabin fever. You know, they want to come to this great destination. We've got great hospitality. I think we've been responsible with whether it's masks, even though that mandate has been lifted, we still encourage it, especially when you're in close quarters. But we are a destination for people to enjoy. Even in the midst of this pandemic, they can do that.
I think there have been a lot of cases where we've gone the extra mile to make sure that it was safe. And man, how much safer can you get than that beach out there?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Councilman Glavan, if someone wanted to email you.
Sure, they can go to kglavan at biloxi.ms.us.
That's K-G-L-A-V-A-N at biloxi.ms.us. Any closing thoughts for the people?
Yeah, you know, our heart is so warmed by, again, the generosity that I mentioned. It shows who we are. We've always been this way, and I want to thank each and every one of the persons and businesses that have contributed to Real Men Wear Pink and other causes during these trying times.
And it's not over, we got all month.
We got all month to do it. October 1st is today. We got 30 something days to take care of business.
I must say, I think you did much better than Felcher.
Well, you know, he's a freshman representative. He's learning every day. He's getting better every day, and he's a great representative.
I'm proud of the job he's done, and Herbie Glavan would be very proud of you, too.
No doubt. He would love to wear pink or pink shoes. You know, he would certainly dress out a lot better than I did.
Thank you.
You're welcome.